डियर स्टूडेंट्स, अस्सलामु अलैकुम, वेलकम टू द क्लास ऑफ इंग्लिश बी। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, हैव यू एवर थॉट हाउ डू वी स्पीक और व्हाई डू वी स्पीक? एक्चुअली इट इज़ द लैंग्वेज, इट इज़ द लैंग्वेज दैट टेल्स अस दैट हाउ डू वी स्पीक एंड व्हाई डू वी स्पीक। वी एक्चुअली have four basic skills of a language: listening, speaking, reading and writing. So now I come to the point that what is a language. So language is a system of sounds, patterns, etc. It is a system of sounds, patterns, etc. Now look here, we have the word school, school, school. We have arranged different sounds in a proper pattern. If we use the same sounds in the second one, but we don't have a proper pattern in this word, so we cannot say that it is a word. The second one, the first one is school, because we have a proper pattern of sounds. Though we have same letters, but we don't have a proper pattern in the second one. In the first one, we have a proper pattern. So now we come to the point that a system of sounds, patterns, etc. We set different sounds in a proper pattern. So you have answered the first question, that how do we speak? A system of sounds, patterns, etc. This is the thing that how we speak. We use different sounds in a proper pattern. So the second question, why do we speak? Actually, we have to communicate our feelings and thoughts with each other. So for the purpose of communication, we speak. Used by human beings to communicate thoughts and feelings. So language is used by human beings to communicate their thoughts and feelings. So how do we speak? We arrange different sounds, patterns, etc. to speak. And why do we speak? To communicate our thoughts and feelings. So both the things combine to form language. So what is a language? A system of sounds, patterns, etc. used by human beings to communicate thoughts and feelings. So now we come to the second point, that how we form different words. Actually, when we speak, so we use different words to communicate with each other, to share our ideas with each other. Actually, these are the words. So how do we form different words, or what is a word? So word, sound or combination of sounds. So it can be only one sound like I and A, or combination of sounds, or the combination of sounds like I have given you the example, the word school. It is combination of sounds. So sound or combination of sounds that expresses a meaning. So school expresses a complete meaning. It is a building, it is an institution, it is the place where you learn, where you learn. So sound or combination of sounds that expresses a meaning and form an independent unit of the grammar. So what do you mean by independent unit of the grammar? Independent unit mean it can be a noun, pronoun, verb, adverb, etc. It means that a class of grammar or vocabulary of a language. Vocabulary means your words that you have in your memory. So what is a word? Sounds or combination of sounds that expresses a meaning and forms an independent unit of the grammar or vocabulary of a language. So a word must be combination of letters or sometimes a single letter. So combination of letter like school, and single letter like I and A. And the second thing, letter must be in proper order. I again come to the example that in school the letters have proper order. In the second option, we have same letters but don't have a proper order, don't have a proper pattern. So the second point is letters must be in proper order, then it would be called as a word. And the third thing is meaningfulness, that a word must give us a meaning. A word must give us a meaning. Without meaningfulness, we cannot say that it is a word. So the word school is giving us a proper meaning, so we can say that it is a word. So the third question that can be arised in your mind, that how we arrange different words to communicate with each other. Have you ever thought that when you speak, you use thousands of words? So how we arrange different words to communicate with each other? So it is actually the grammar. It is the grammar that tells us that how you have to arrange different words. So what is grammar? Study of rules for forming words and combining them into sentences. Study of rules for forming words. First, that how to form words. As I have told you earlier, that we arrange different sounds in proper pattern to make words. So study of rules for forming words and combining them into sentences. Then we combine these words into sentences in proper order. Like, I have a sentence, I go to school. It has a proper order. Different words have proper order. But I cannot say that go to school I. Go school I too. Because it does not have a proper order. So the words must contain a proper order. Or a set of rules about a language is called grammar. So what is grammar? Study of rules for forming words and combining them into sentences. Or a set of rules about a language is called grammar. So students, today we have studied three basic things, that what is language, what is a word, and what is grammar. So first I asked you two questions. That how do we speak? Why do we speak? So it is the language because of which we communicate with each other. We arrange different words to speak, and we for the purpose of communication, we speak to each other. So the second question I asked you, how we arrange different words to communicate with each other. So actually it is the grammar that tells us that in which way we have to arrange different words to communicate with each other. And how we form different words, we use different sounds in a proper pattern to make words. So we have discussed three points today: language, word, and grammar. So your homework would be these five questions. How do we speak? You have to answer me in written form. Why do we speak? And how we arrange different words to communicate with each other? And how we form different words? Thank you so much.